Let's go to re-election. You did not face a serious challenger in your re-election race, and yet you've added millions to your campaign war chest. There is some talk that you may potentially be considering a run for higher office, possibly U.S. Senate. Is there any truth to that?
No. There's an old saying, those who talk don't know, and those who know don't talk. I think that was on full display. Zero intention or interest in running statewide this cycle. I've got an amazing job.
This cycle.
I've got an amazing job. I'm running for re-election.
So if we threw president on the table, you would say no to that, too?
I have an amazing job. I'm running for re-election.
Right. Very good. Very good.
You're ruling out, just to be clear, you're ruling out a run for U.S. Senate this cycle.
Yes. As I said in Playbook a couple days ago, I am running for re-election to the U.S. House. I have an amazing job, amazing constituents, and I got a lot of work ahead of me.
What about the future?
I don't close doors on the future. I have found in my career that hard work plus timing is the recipe, and you can't predict one of those. So
let's move on to a lightning round. Some quick questions, quick answers. Let's start with the Green Line. Big deal in your district. Are you confident Governor Healey can get the MBTA back on the rails?
I have great confidence in Governor Healey. I know she takes it seriously, and I want to see the Federal Transit Agency's report met in all of its recommendations.
Well, and speaking of that, would you like to see even more federal oversight? Obviously, the FTA is working with the T, but would you like to see oversight, more of that?
I want to see this T have a new regulator at the state level, and the state and lawmakers are working on moving it from the DPU to a different agency. I think that's appropriate. I think the FTA has done its most important job by putting forth the recommendations, and they will absolutely be back to check on progress, and I'll help the FTA meet
that
accountability.
And just on that, which agency do you think is best equipped to oversee this?
I think that's for the governor and lawmakers to decide, but it's clear that the DPU is not it.
Will Kevin McCarthy be holding the gavel at the next State of the Union?
I can't predict the House GOP in that circus. It took him 15 tries to get him in office. Who knows what would happen if he yielded the gavel?
What was it like on the floor when that was happening? Was it uncomfortable? Was it government working? What was it?
I mean, it was mostly boring because I just said the same name 15 straight times. Democrats were not confused about who we wanted to see, a dynamic young leader at the helm. It really was interesting to watch, though, Kevin McCarthy have a choice between going hard right or going center, because he could have reached out and said, I need help, Democrats, like, let's work on this. And instead he went hard right. And that unfortunately has set the tone for the first month in Congress.
All right. In a Harvard MIT geek showdown, who wins?
MIT.
Oh, there you go.
Well, this next question is about your dad. Your dad has taken over for Anthony Fauci at the National Institutes of Health. Do you call him when the kids have a runny nose?
Actually, it was Ashish Jha, who I spent the first year of the pandemic talking to frequently. A lot of my constituents will remember we did video back and forth, that he was such an incredible presence helping inform people. But my dad is the one who taught me about public service growing up, about the importance of it, the integrity that goes into it. And I got great confidence in his ability to helm that important agency.
Dr. Ashish Jha, he was on ABC News frequently, as a matter of fact.
Dr. Ashish Jha,
speaking about it, to that very point you're talking about.
He's probably the best public health communicator in America.
Great to see you.
You as well. Thanks for having me.
We wish him and you well.
Appreciate it.